Hey, hey, good evening. This is Alejandro Narbona on behalf of Inglés Corporativo. How's it going, Alison? How are you today?
Teacher, well, fine. What about you?
Good, you know, I can't complain. Still alive.
I am. Yeah, me too.
So that's a win-win situation, right?
Yes, I know. Yeah, teacher, I have a question.
Tell me.
When we are going to finish this module?
When are we?
When are we going? Okay.
We have 3 weeks left. This one and two more. So.
Okay, I was asking because of the invitation to the inscription to the sixth module.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. The thing is that they normally try to do it ahead of time, because it takes time for human resources to, you know, send the documentation. So they try to do it ahead of time, and we don't take longer time. When did you receive that invitation?
I received it today.
Okay. All right. You know what, Alison? I'm going to need your help before the class ends, or at the middle of the class when I have more people. I'm going to talk a little bit about it.
Okay.
So please try. Let me see. Let's see at 8:30 to see if inscription. To see if we
and
have
there
more people
is another added. Group, like one from Saturdays or Sundays, or just in the week.
To be honest with you, I'm not really sure. In the meantime, let me go ahead and say hi to JC and Maria Isabel. Thank you very much for logging in. That was when we were face to face. We had courses on site on weekends, but with this pandemic, I'm not sure if they will open any course online. I'm not sure. That is entirely up to InstaFort.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome, guys. Okay, so thank you, Gladys, for being here. Really happy that you have been able to survive another weekend, so that's good. Now, as far as the topic, do you remember what was last Friday's topic?
No, the invitation. Look, information questions. No.
We worked with those type of questions. Yes.
Yeah, but it was not the main idea.
But mainly?
Well, no.
Remember that Thursday was pure grammar, reported speech, information questions. Then we have some hidden charges, remember?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Uh-huh. The Friday.
Yes, on Friday. We were working with hidden charges. In what situations can we expect hidden charges? Do you guys remember the different scenarios that we covered?
Restaurant, hospitals, credit cards.
Okay, good. Let's go ahead and work with credit cards. What kind of hidden fees can we have with credit cards?
The credit cards.
When you pay before to the finish the contract,
uh-huh.
To have a day to put a fees for pay before.
Correct. And how do we call that? How do we call charge. When we have a charge, what's that?
Charge.
Fees.
A fee. Correct. Fees. And what fees. Kind of fee do we have when we want to cancel a contract?
It was a charge fee or a cancellation fee.
There you go. It was a cancellation fee. That's right. Now, there was another one. Welcome, Aldo. Welcome, Eric. I think I already welcome you, Gladys. There is a fee that you asked me. This was new vocabulary to you. What is the fee that they charge you when you're filing a dispute. Do you remember? There's a fee.
The trial fee?
Yeah. Is that the word?
With triple?
Yep. Or was it?
It was a chargeback.
A chargeback, yeah.
Which is pretty much like a retrieval fee. Yes, exactly.
Retrieval fee.
Mm-hmm. So this is as far as credit cards, right? Then as far as hospitals, what hidden charges can we have?
Hidden fees.
Even the toilet paper.
Okay. What else?
For special food.
Special food, that's right. Medication. Mm-hmm. Exams.
If you are in a private room.
If you're in a private room, that's right. Sometimes they don't tell you. Have you ever been to a hospital and they have to call a specialist?
No.
Yes, me once.
What happens?
Do
they mention that the specialist charges more? Or they just add it to the bill?
No, actually they didn't, because it was a public hospital.
Oh, okay. Public hospital.
Mm-hmm. So they need to call a specialist, but they didn't charge me.
Oh, okay. Got it. Well, of those who don't know, whenever you are in a private hospital and they call a specialist, they charge you more.
Yep.
They charge you way, way, way more. And they just add it to your bill. Sometimes they don't tell you.
And it's not just the salary what the specialist will charge. It's that they charge you because the specialist will use their installations, their chairs, their supplies and things. So they charge you for rent to the specialist the things that another one will use on you.
Okay. That's a good point. Good. It is a great time, guys, for me to remind you that whenever we are using a preposition and we have the name of an action, we use gerund. So for plus gerunds. For example, I'm writing it down on the chat. Thank you for coming. How do you say gracias por llamar?
Thank you for calling.
Thank you for calling, right? They charge you for renting their, how do you say instalaciones in English?
Installations?
Connections? Uh-huh, but not installation like you're installing a computer. I'm talking about the building, about the rooms.
Building charge?
Almost there, almost there. Facilities, that's right. So, vocabulary, guys. Like I said, this is a very particular topic we gotta cover, but I'm gonna try to give you as much vocabulary as I can. So facilities, as it's written in the chat, is actually the place, right? A pool is part of the facilities, a meeting room, the restrooms, the parking, the garden, all of that is part of the facilities of a place. Okay, so guys, today we're gonna be closing up. Well, not really closing up, but adding up some more information about this topic. Question. We already talked about this, but it's kind of reinforcing. Have you ever received a damaged product to your house? Like a pizza with a pepperoni on top of the box, or something you ordered that arrived in poor condition?
Nope.
Nope. Okay, I figured that you were going to say something like that.
Yeah, so that's yes.
So that's why I actually have something to show you, but give me just a minute.
Yes, one is.
I'm gonna share my screen with you guys. Okay, so I'm gonna play it with you, and you let me know what you think. If there's any new vocabulary, please.
Christmas may be a couple weeks away, but for those in charge of making sure all your trinkets and treasures make it in time, the season's onslaught is happening right now. Millions upon millions of packages are winging their way across the country as I speak. One of the busiest shipping nights of all time. ABC's John Donvan brings us behind the scenes look at the people who are hard at work trying to outdo the big man up north.
Okay, I had this video preloaded, but apparently it's giving a little bit of issues. I'm gonna play it again. My camera.
The story of a pie in a box at. Christmas time, and of the many people who helped get it from point A
off to Honolulu
to point B.
I hope it's something good.
Which is the story of FedEx, which, like UPS and the U.S. Postal Service, is how Christmas gets handled nowadays.
I'm shipping a handcrafted, welded metal bookend.
Especially today, the busiest day of the year for FedEx, shipping an estimated 19 million packages, thanks to the start of the busiest week of the year for online shopping.
Now I'm scrambling to keep up.
For the rest of the procrastinators, there are still 14 shopping days left, which translates into how many shipping days? Well, that depends on what you're sending and how much you're willing to spend. Even though the U.S. Postal Service can be cheaper, if you're down to the wire, FedEx and UPS can save the day with last-minute deliveries. Which brings us back to our pie, which I picked up in the historic little town of Occoquan, Virginia, from a friendly little place called, well, you see the sign.
Hi.
Hi.
John.
Avis, how are you?
Meet Mom. Avis Renshaw.
Then we move into cherries.
And as Ava showed me what was on offer, I explained that I had it in mind to send the pie to my friend and colleague, Yunji Denise.
Good evening, I'm Yunji Denise.
One-time ABC News reporter, now happily anchoring the news at station KITV in Honolulu, Hawaii. Distance involved, roughly 6,000 miles. My deadline for getting the pie to her, 24 hours.
Have you sent pies to Hawaii before? And they get there in one piece?
Amazingly, but yes, they do.
Cranberry apple. That's what went into the FedEx box. For precious or fragile items, best to leave the packaging to the professionals.
Have a great day.
And our pie is out the door. First human link in the FedEx chain, the first of many.
I placed the pie securely in one designated area of my truck.
For the next few hours, you see that purple line? That's our pie on its journey, headed for Memphis, Tennessee. Why Memphis? Well, look at this place. It is FedEx's global super hub, which at more than 800 acres feels more like a military base than a shipping facility. And with Christmas approaching, it's a military base that's gearing up for battle.
It's what we prepare for. It's our Super Bowl. So
this is your Super Bowl.
This is our Super Bowl.
Marcus Martinez keeps the planes running on time, and the vans and the trucks and 42 miles of conveyor belts. Every FedEx package is sent first to a hub like this before going on its journey.
How big a surge comes in the holiday season?
Here in Memphis, we'll go from about 1.5 million a night to a little between 1.9 and 2.1 million a night.
FedEx 1563, pushback approved, 18 right.
Let's check in on our pie, which they were kind enough to track just for us. It's coming in for a landing soon, so out onto the tarmac, where it's nonstop on the runways.
Okay, so these are now all incoming still.
Exactly. We're going to bring in about 155 jet aircraft tonight.
Tonight alone. How busy does this place get compared to other airports?
Well, after dark, it's actually the busiest airport in the world.
Come on, y'all, bring them out!
In fact, most of the work here happens after midnight. Timing is everything. Back in the command center and on screens all over, a clock is counting down the deadline for getting all the packages in and out again. And then our pie is now safely on the ground. thanks to these two members of the Nightline Pie delivery team.
Thanks to a fine landing by my first officer here, the pie made it in one piece.
Normally, the pie would be in one of these shipping containers.
So where's our pie?
We have your pie right here.
But for now, it's being carried so that we can track it through our next stop. They call this the Matrix.
If you stand here for 15 minutes, you will see the world's economy pass before your eyes.
It's a whole building functioning as a sorting machine. The incoming packages slide in here.
You will see major tech shipments. You will see medical shipments.
And a pie.
And a pot.
Into the Matrix goes our box with the pie inside. Courtesy of Lawrence Wick.
The package never stopped coming, so I got to get back to start sorting, okay?
And the box, well, once it drops out of sight into some hidden place of chutes and conveyor belts and scanners, it gets steered by belt to another building. 10 minutes later, it comes down a chute and gets picked up and put into a container.
Off to Honolulu.
And then it's out to the runway and takeoff. And 6 hours later, landing in Hawaii, our last driver to deliver.
I hope this is something that you're waiting for.
I hope it's something good.
Ooh.
And happy holidays, Yunji.
Thanks, John.
Well, don't just thank me. Avis and Diane and John and Bill and Marcus and Lawrence and Paul and Mel and Greg and Daryl all had a hand in getting you that pie. I'm John Donvan for Nightline.
All right, guys, so after this video about international shipping, I have a couple of things before we continue. How do you say banda sin fin, where they transport the packages?
Endless banda.
Uh-huh.
Endless belt?
Almost. It has belt in it. So that's a conveyor belt. Especially for, I got a couple of students here working in the airport, I think. That's a conveyor belt. How do you call it in Spanish, guys? What is the right name of that?
Banda transportadora.
Okay, banda transportadora.
Banda de equipaje, segundo.
Oh, banda de equipaje. So that's a conveyor belt. And that is actually more common than what you think. How do you say sin detenerse?
Non-stop.
Without stop.
Non-stop.
Non-stop.
Literally, non-stop. How do you say estivar? Or in this case, to pack or to store? No?
Stow.
Stow? Stow, correct. This verb, guys, is stow. So that's pretty much to pack, estivar, right? You can actually use it. How do you say despegar? Talking about planes.
Take off.
Take off.
Take off. Aterrizar.
Landing.
Landing.
Landing. All right. Now, guys, I'm pretty sure that after this exercise, you're going to have a lot of questions. I wanted to go into the groups because I have things written down and talk about the whole process that you saw. If you have ever had any doubts about it, any comments, have you ever lost something? Do you think that items can suffer any damage? Will you get them intact? All right, to give your opinion about it. But before that, any question about vocabulary?
Yet.
Out of 6 minutes, you didn't get anything as new vocabulary?
How do you say a stole in Spanish?
Like estivar.
In Spanish, what's the meaning?
How can we explain estivar? It's like to put everything in the right order, almacenar en el...
Cargar, almacenar.
Cargar, almacenar en el orden...
Okay.
Adecuado.
Sí.
Mm-hmm. Anything else is new vocabulary?
Procrastinating.
Which one?
Procrastinated.
Oh, man.
Procrastinate.
That's a beautiful word, but very dangerous. Can anybody explain what procrastination is?
It's like to do nothing with your time, something like that.
Exactly, for you. Time? For you not to do anything, for you to leave everything for the last minute, like a good Salvadorians we are. All right, so to procrastinate is to postpone the things in time. I gotta go to the store. Nah, I'm gonna go tomorrow. Okay, so that's gonna be it. Give me a second.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome. Anything else as far as vocabulary? Okay, so if there's no questions, guys, this is what we're gonna do. Remember, try to keep your camera on at all times. Try to, you all have your names according to your DUI. And this is just gonna be a 3-minute quick chat, guys. What do you think about the video? I mean, it's, to me, that's completely crazy. You have to be great at time management. You have to have a lot of people working for you. There's a big team involved just for shipping one pie 6,000 miles away from Tennessee to Hawaii. All right, so go ahead and accept it. You're gonna have 3 minutes, discuss the video, then we come back and we have some more. Ready? There we go. Please accept the invite. I'm gonna get Daniel here. Aldo Celia is waiting for you.
Nice. Doing good. So we're going to discuss about the video.
Yes.
Okay. But it's a general discussion, right?
Yeah, general discussion. What you think? Comments?
I think it's like really, how do you say, poco probable or
unlikely.
Unlikely
that the pies were like
intact.
Intact.
Uh-huh.
But I think.
You see, Camila, great.
Yes.
Share it with the group. When we go back, share it with the group what you learned.
Okay. And because the pies were like in a lot of hands and it was intact from this place to this place, so was amazing to see that.
Yes.
To saw that the pies were.
To see, it is correct.
To see.
To see that the pies were intact, yes.
Okay, so that's my opinion.
Okay, so you think that that is also a hard work that the people do in UPS and FedEx? I mean, in order to take everything.
Yeah.
Pretty amazing because I didn't know about the process that I take to send like a package from a place to another one, so I think that was incredible.
Yeah, maybe that's why some of your things toman mucho tiempo.
Take a long time.
Oh. Take a long time. Tomando nota.
Yeah. No, take a long time. Toman mucho tiempo. Take a long time.
Yeah, take. Maybe that's why the things sometimes take a long time to get to your house.
But that was done within 24 hours, Alison. They sent the package within 24 hours.
Yeah, but because they are basically close. Or it's just from deliveries and close.
Okay. Within the state. Oh, dentro okay, de, within.
we didn't say. Yeah, because if you ask for something from another country, it takes maybe a few days.
Yep, that's right. All right, continue. We still got a few minutes, and then we go back.
¿Cómo se dice? Actúa o interpreta.
Plays.
Employee of Felix.
Plays the role of.
Plays the role of.
Play, like playing soccer or basketball.
Oh. No. He is working as an employee of FedEx, and the airplane has a problem and crashed over the ocean. And then he goes to an island. He survives and goes to an island. And like 3 years later, he gets rescued. Nice. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Plays the role of a FedEx employee.
Employee, the pronunciation goes up. Employee.
Oh, yes. Employee. Okay.
Employee. Okay.
So that movie is Cast Away. That's the name in English, Cast Away. Do you like it? Naufrago?
I love it.
Yeah, I love it too, man.
I've never seen.
I have never watched.
Would you recommend it, Antonio? Ernesto Antonio?
Yes, I recommend that movie, and I recommend the actor too. Maybe you can see also Sully.
Yeah, the one landing the plane.
In the New York River.
Yep, I saw it too. Hey guys, Antonio is giving you good recommendations. That movie lasts like 2 hours, but it's worth it. Vale la pena. All right.
Wow.
Continue, guys. Let me check how the last group is doing.
Okay.
And it comes from they come from Brazil, and the other ones come from China. Yes. So they use FedEx. Yes, it's really interesting. But there in the US, it's really commonly use FedEx between the people you know, because of the distance.
Yeah, it's a long distance between. Yeah.
For example.
Many part of companies.
Yeah. Here in El Salvador, I don't know a company of how do you say delivery?
Yeah.
I mean company delivery. That is specialized in delivery, all these kind of boxes and things. I mean everything you want.
You can call it like delivery services.
I saw a couple of enterprise. For example, I see a motorcycle, to have a printed in the motorcycle. Rapidito, te lo trae, mandadito. It's the how do you say propaganda?
Advertising.
Advertising.
Keep it in mind. Let's go back to the main room, guys.
Okay.
Hey, Rotana. Good to see you. People is coming back.
Good evening. Thank you.
I was going to come back real soon. We were having some discussion here.
Okay. Thanks.
No, thanks to you for logging in. I appreciate it. Okay, guys. So most of you are back. I need a volunteer to give your opinion about the video. Please. Morena, thank you. Go ahead. I see you raising your hand, so.
Okay. It's a tricky, I think.
Uh-huh. What is your opinion about the shipping thing?
About the shipping thing, well, for FedEx, it's really famous company, I think. And they have really a big logistic in this case for shipping all package of the people in this country, in this case is in the United States from another countries, right? And I think they are, it's a really complicated process.
Process, nice fix. Yeah, process. The stress in the first process, out. Process.
Process, okay. It's a difficult process, but they try to ship all of things to the people.
Everything?
Everything to the people. And then I think maybe it's not perfect, but they try to send in the everything on time, but maybe not in perfect condition, I think.
Okay.
Not necessary, I think.
Okay, that's a nice point of view you're talking about, Morena. Do you guys think that most of the packages arrive in perfect or mint condition, like the flavor, mint condition?
I think so. See, I have seen some.
No, they don't.
In some of them, I think that the most part of them come correctly, I think.
Okay, all right. And that's actually exactly what we're going to talk about. Andrea, I actually heard an interesting comment about you.
An interesting comment about you.
Well, that you actually made about this video. Would you mind sharing it with the group?
That you actually made about this video. Would you mind sharing it with the group?
I don't remember what I said. But probably my point of view is that it was like, I was like amazed about the whole process, because I didn't have like the idea of what it takes to send a package from a place to another one. So I think that it was amazing to get it to know what the process is.
Okay, great. Thank you, Andrea. She was, for the ones who had issues hearing, I think you're having a little bit of connectivity issues, Andrea, but it was clear to me. She was amazed. She was not aware on how the process was, among other things. All right. So how do you say abollado?
Crushed.
Bent.
Uh-huh. How do you say roto, pero en papel?
Scratch. No.
Hmm. How do you say roto en madera?
Broken.
There we go. So we're going to be working with that vocabulary today, because guess what, guys? The delivery shipping process is not perfect, and you're going to have issues with the delivery. But before that, some of you guys ask me for vocabulary, and I want you to share. If you ask for vocabulary, you got to use it. Otherwise, it's useless. Comes right here, X is this way, and boom, it's out. So for the ones that I provided new vocabulary, please go ahead and share what you've learned. Or like in every single group I joined, I gave you new vocabulary. Allison, I think I gave you something. Ernesto, I gave you something too, I think. JC, you got new words too. Those are the ones I remember. Uh-huh. What is the new vocabulary I shared? I don't know, you tell me.
Non-stop?
Nope. Right in the conversation, guys. You ask me, some of you, how do you say blah, blah, blah? And I gave you the answer. So, delivery service, you got it. Gladys has some. What else? Juan Carlos.
Advertising.
Advertising, exactly. Uh-huh. What about Tom Hanks, Ernesto? What does he do in the movie you were talking about?
Play the role.
Exactly, to play the role. Allison, I think I gave you one too, but I don't really remember.
Not really.
Okay, so the point is this, guys. Every time that you ask for new vocabulary, write it down and use it immediately. Otherwise, it happens that you forget. Okay, so now let's go ahead and play a, well, I'm not gonna play something. What word, what do you think is the meaning of torn? You can use the internet, guys. If I tell you the jacket lining is torn, it's in the chat. Who can give me the meaning of that?
The jacket lining is...
Dañado.
Rasgado.
I'm sorry, Aldo?
Rasgado.
Ah, okay, so torn is that, what you're mentioning. Can wood be torn?
No.
Can plastic be torn?
Yes.
Maybe.
Okay. What other materials can get torn?
Some kind of baggage.
Okay. Some kinds of baggage. What else?
Clothing.
Uh-huh. What else?
Leather.
Organs.
Shoes.
Oh, muscles, you're saying? Or organs? What about paper? Can paper be torn?
Yeah.
Okay. So, how do you say mi camisa está rasgada?
My t-shirt is torn.
Uh-huh. My shirt is torn, or it has a tear in it. Guys, write it down because I'm giving you vocabulary that you can use not only in packages, delivery situation, but also in your personal life, right?
It has a tear in it.
Tear.
So you have two ways of saying it. Está rasgada o tiene un pequeño hoyo.
Tear, like a lágrima.
Yes, exactly. It has a tear, like a little hole.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so how do you say mi maleta tiene está rasgada? Mi maleta.
My baggage has a tear on it.
Remember? Oh, that's a beautiful thing. The difference between on and in. We're going to cover it in a second. I like that one. So my suitcase, for example, or my bag.
My back
is torn. There are two different ways of saying it. Now, real quick, how do you say mi maleta o mi bolso tiene un hoyo?
My bag has a tear.
My baggage has a hole.
Aha. Vaya, guys. Baggage and luggage is equipaje. Right?
Luggage, yeah.
Uh-huh. Luggage and baggage is the same thing, equipaje. You can use it interchangeably and there's no problem. The difference is that an idiom, you can have a baggage on your shoulder. I think I explained that to you already. But you're going to have luggage on your shoulder.
No.
No, I didn't?
No.
You did.
No? All right. So let me explain that to you. That's a phrase. When you have a lot in your mind, like a lot of problems, like a lot of responsibility, you can use baggage. I have a lot of baggage on my shoulders, right? It's like a synonym of weight. I have a lot of
baggage on my shoulders.
On my shoulders, right? A lot of responsibilities. That is the only different way that you can use baggage on. You cannot say, I have a lot of luggage on my shoulders, because that means you have a lot of suitcase and you're carrying them physically, right? But luggage and baggage is the same, despite this. Aparte de esto, esta excepción, luggage and baggage es lo mismo. Okay, equipaje. Now, if you're talking about suitcase, about a bag, about a carry-on bag, do you know what is the meaning of carry-on bag?
Is that like a handbag?
It's a little... When in the cabin, the
equipaje. La maleta de mano. Usa ese equipaje de mano.
Uh-huh. And the one with your rolls.
Ajá, la que tienes rodos. That's a carry-on bag. Right? It's a carry-on bag. La que tiene roditos, usted que la lleva de, a todos lados. All right, so you can say, for example, like, it has, my carry-on bag has a hole or a tear, is the same, in it. All right, we're gonna see the difference. Now, guys, what is the meaning of damaged?
Dañado.
Dañado.
And synonyms in English?
Look on the internet.
Yeah, come on, guys. When it's about vocabulary, I know. Not working.
Okay.
So yes, when something is damaged, it's not working, right? Or at least not working properly. Because you can have something that is useless. Useless is, how do you say useless in Spanish? It has no use. It has no use. Inútil. Ya está desahuciado, muerto, caput.
Also broken?
Or broken. Correct.
Long gone.
Long gone, dead and gone. So, what things can get damaged?
Glass.
What?
Uh-huh. A glass. What do you think, guys?
Everything you can...
Uh-huh.
Computer, cell phones.
Electronics. TV,
electronics. In general, electronics.
Uh-huh. Can a car get damaged?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Can a cell phone get damaged?
Yes.
Yes.
Uh-huh. What else can get damaged?
Furniture.
Appliances.
Furniture. Yeah, you will see. Furniture, you can actually say is damaged, but doesn't really fit much. I'll explain to you why, but I'm gonna write it down. Okay, what else? ¿Qué más se les puede dañar, guys?
The food, but I think that is not the correct word.
Uh-huh, very good. You are totally correct. How do you say que la comida ya está dañada?
Rotten.
Rotten, right? Podrida. So you see, guys, there are different adjectives for different materials and scenarios, and that's what we're going to work with right now. So rotten, you can use it with food, for example. Food and beverages. Okay? Now, let's go ahead and work with chipped.
Teacher,
mm-hmm.
What is beverages?
Different kinds of drinks.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. Horchata, is horchata a beverage?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yep, it is. Water? Mm-hmm. Beverage. Yes. Beer?
Yes.
Yes.
Ay, sí, todos contestaron. Okay, so let's go ahead and continue. We also have chipped. What do you think is the meaning of chipped?
Quebrado.
Uh-huh. Something like that. For example, there's a lot of people in OLX selling phones, right? Oh, the screen is chipped, but astillado. Other than that, exactly, like astillado. So what kind of materials can get chipped?
Wood.
Wood.
Glass.
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 Plates.
Aha, plates. Ceramic. Some plates are made of ceramic.
A lamp? Maybe.
Yeah, but we can talk about the material itself. It can get chipped. Mm-hmm. So wood, glass, plastic. Good. Real quick. How do you say, what is the meaning of this? Try to do it in English.
Stained.
You got a spot on your clothes?
A spot on your clothes, that's right. Mm-hmm. So there's a little stain. Stain, stained, manchado. What can get stained? What kind of materials?
Clothing.
Clothes.
Cotton.
Some furniture, the couch.
Okay, a couch.
Any surface.
A bed.
Any surface.
Clothes.
Almost.
The sofa. Metals,
walls.
Okay, a metal, wood.
Wood, ceramics.
Uh-huh.
Any kind of
rubber.
Rubber, that's right, materials. Almost any kind of surface can get stained. Next one real quick. Scratched.
Rayado.
Como arañazos.
Ajá, pero no el queso. Eso es grated. That's a different thing. That's a different animal. So scratched is, you know, when you get in trouble with your girl, you can get, you can end up all scratched, right?
Yeah.
Okay, gracias. All right, very good. So what materials, guys, can get scratched? Can we scratch clothes?
No.
No. We can? Turn them, right?
Turn them.
Tear torn. Good. Can we scratch wood?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Wood, metal.
Metal.
Ceramic.
Cement.
Ceramic. Yeah, the ceramic can get scratched. Glass.
Glass.
Uh huh.
Right.
The painting of your car.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Etc. So, guys, let's go ahead and recap before we continue because I don't want to give you like 1,000 terms. We got torn. What is the meaning of torn in Spanish?
Rasgado.
Rasgado.
Right. What kind of materials can get torn?
Plastic, clothing,
plastic,
baggage,
clothes,
paper.
Clothes. Yeah, depending on the type of plastic. Okay, remember that, depending on the type of plastic. Because if it's hard, that's broken, not torn. Right?
Yeah.
Good. What about damaged? What kind of things can get damaged?
Car, electrical devices.
Electronics. Mm-hmm. Electronics. Furniture.
Right. Like, for example, any device, not... How do you say materia prima?
Good. Raw material?
Raw material. That's right. Materia prima. So normally those are materials. But things already built for a purpose are the ones that get damaged most of the times. Right? The things that have a use. Very good. What about rotten? What can get rotten?
Food and beverage.
Food and beverages, that's right. Chipped, what is the meaning of chipped?
Astillado.
Astillado, las famosas pantallas de los teléfonos en OLX, vea. Detalle mínimo, de glass, chipped, right? Solo para conocedores. Stained.
Clothes.
Manchado.
Manchado.
Clothes, metal, great. Scratched.
Wood,
arañado,
metal,
arañado,
paint.
Uh-huh, paint, exactly. And I got one that, well, I'm going to leave it for the last. Next one, cracked. What do you think is the meaning of cracked?
Crack.
It's like a synonym of broken.
It is a synonym of broken, right? But someone said it in Spanish.
Agrietado.
That's right. So that's a crack, right? What kind of materials can get cracked?
Some kind of
ceramic,
ceramic, plastic. Uh huh.
The
concrete.
Salt.
The brick in the walls after a shake.
Okay, bricks, that's right. So cement, right? So it can get cracked. Puede agrietarse. Now, I think this is the last one. I don't want to give you that much. Dent. What is the meaning of dent?
Abollado,
right? Nowadays cars, if you lay on a car, it is very possible for you to leave a dent on the fender or the hood or the door or anywhere you lay. Right, so abollados, what kind of material can get dented? Can get dent?
Metal, spare parts,
yep, depending on the material.
What is that?
Aluminium. Spare parts is spare, something you have in case the original thing or the original part gets broken, then you have a spare.
Mm.
So for example, in the trunk of your car, you normally have a spare tire.
Yeah.
Right? So
okay.
That's the meaning. All right. Very good, guys. This is pretty much things that we're going to be using today. Okay? Any questions with the vocabulary? Nope. Okay. I missed one. What is the meaning of leak?
Una fuga.
Fuga.
And it's leaking water.
Exactly. And this is normally in ing. Why? Because if you have a leak, it continues going back and forth. Mm-hmm. So you're going to say, how do you say, el baño está goteando?
Leaking water.
The toilet is leaking.
Okay. The toilet is leaking. ¿Hay una fuga en el baño?
The sink is leaking.
Or the sink. So you have two options right there. You can say the toilet is leaking or there is a leak in the toilet.
I have a question here.
Go ahead.
I used to say, when I tried to say something like that, something, I used to say dripping water. And nobody corrects me, but I think that is because they laugh on me. Is right to say that or not?
Dripping?
Dripping water.
Like normally your nose is dripping?
Uh-huh. But I want to try to explain that a leak of water in some place of the tube or something. I used to say, oh, it's dripping water. And
it's not
and
drop,
nobody,
drop.
Nobody corrects me.
No, I would say leak. I would definitely say leak. Because the thing is that when you say dripping, it's like very wet, right? That is actually, for example, if you get a lot of water in your head, of course your body is gonna be leaking the water, but your hair is actually dripping.
Mm-hmm.
So yes, it's like goteo, but I think it depends on the context. I would use leak. Or they might be synonyms. So I would use leak.
I don't know. I don't speak English.
Yes, you do. Yep. All right. So in that one, I might have to look for the difference. I would say that they are synonyms, but I would use leak. I would prefer leak. If there's a difference, I'm going to have to find out. Mm-hmm. Oh, you know what? I got it. As nouns, the difference between leak and drip is that leap is a crack, a hole, right? And drip is excess of something.
Okay, like you said in your hair, is excess of water in your hair.
Exactly. So
that the water is not coming from the inside of the skull of the hair.
That's right. That's the one that I can get from a little quick research. When there's a leak, there's a crack. Hey, I like that phrase. When there's a leak, there's a crack. And when it's dripping, it's like you have too much. Food can actually drip. Have you ever baked something with butter? When you lift it, it actually drips.
Uh-huh.
Right? It's not leaking because there's no crack.
Uh-huh.
Better now?
See. See, now I know.
Yep.
Okay, great.
Was that so bad?
Okay. All right, guys. Before we continue, because like I said, the topic is very similar as we were talking in the past couple of days. So I'm trying to give you some more vocabulary so you can apply it. Okay. Now I need some victims. Marcela, how do you say gotera? There you go. Let me see. Amy, how do you say abolladura?
Dent.
Very good. Celia, how do you say rajado?
Cracked.
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 Uh-huh, we go crack, three sounds. Good job.
Cracked.
Abner, how do you say arañado? You got this, boy, you got this. Búscalo, búscalo, look for it. In the meantime, para mientras, Ernesto, how do you say manchado?
Stain.
Beatriz, how do you say astillado?
Second. Chipped.
Very good. Eric, how do you say podrido?
Rotten.
Good. Aldo, how do you say que no funciona?
Damaged.
Very good. Juan Carlos, how do you say rasgado?
Torn.
Good. Thank you very much. Abner, do you have your answer already? Alrighty, let's help him out. How do you say manchado?
Stain.
That's right. Stain. Okay, guys, let me go ahead and take attendance real quick. It's time. Make sure you all have your camera on for the attendance. Today is the 17th. Andrea Mazoquin, Andrea Maria Mazoquin. No. Andrea del Carmen Martín Sarabón.
Here.
Okay, present. Here. I see you. Javier Rodrigo Ayala Cordova. Oh, I think I won't see him again. Daniel Edgardo Cañizales Ventura. I see you. Cañizales or Canizales?
Canizales con N.
Got it. Gladys Idalia Meléndez Hernández.
Present.
I see you. Aldo Sadi Castro Pleites.
Present.
Eric Arnaldo Celaya Ayala. Celada Ayala. I see you.
Present.
Ernesto Antonio Castillo.
Present.
Amy Melissa Rosa Palacios. Amy.
Present.
Okay. Thank you. David Orlando Nerio.
Present.
Marcela Beatriz López Pira.
Present.
I see you. Roxana Domitile Ríos de Quiñones.
Present.
Juan Carlos García Laínez.
Present.
There you are, Jay-Z. Beatriz Adriana Martínez Merino.
Present.
Abner Alexis Martínez Rivas. I see you. Born in Guadalupe, Melara Cruz.
No,
okay, I see. Alison Isabel Ayala Alfaro.
Present.
Okay, I see you. Celia Carmina Pineda Ábalos.
Present.
See you too. Karen Elin García Benítez.
Present.
I see you. Sara Elizabeth Ruiz Ortiz. Give me a second. All right. Let's go ahead and continue. Give me a second. So some of you were actually mentioning, guys, that you think that is very unlikely. That was a word that I told someone. That is very unlikely for the packages to arrive. How do you say buena condición?
Good condition.
Okay. Y así como super buena.
Better condition.
Good condition, or you can say mint condition, like the flavor. M-I-N-T.
What?
Mint condition. So guys, the answer to that question is no. They do not always arrive in mint condition. So that's why I'm going to show you one last video so we can finish up and start working in groups. Give me a second here. Here it is. As you know, I'm gonna turn the video off because of the bandwidth.
Tis the season for packages, and next time you open one intact, be grateful this didn't happen to it. This was a computer monitor tossed over a gate in Southern California by a FedEx delivery man. But then the surveillance camera video was delivered to YouTube and made the news. And now FedEx is saying, we have seen the video and frankly, we were all shocked. But that's not the only drop-off memorialized on YouTube.
Handle with care. Oh, yeah, just like that. Ground service. I get it. Ground. You throw the on the ground.
And it's not just FedEx.
What can Brown do for you?
UPS Brown can toss your package underhand. It can toss it overhand.
Heavy and hard.
It can toss it like a horseshoe. Fences and gates are the delivery man's nemesis. As a driver posted, from a delivery point of view, gates are hostile. Don't like it? Get rid of the gate. The guys videoing this UPS delivery man compared his technique to loading garbage.
Think there's anything gonna be damaged in there? Nah.
Of course it could be worse. At least they're not Ace Ventura. Of all the special deliveries we saw, none was more special than this by FedEx. There were sparks coming off the box at the man who was shooting.
This guy has no idea that he is pushing an oven.
As for the computer monitor heaved over the gate, the person who posted it says the monitor was broken, and it's sad because he was home at the time if the delivery man had just rung the bell. I'm sure what you're probably wondering is, does this guy still have a job?
Right.
FedEx tells CNN, we have ID'd the employee involved. He is being handled according to our internal disciplinary policies.
Federal Express, when it absolutely positively has to be there overnight.
They said overnight, not in one piece. But now that everyone has a camera, it doesn't pay for the delivery elves to get sloppy. Jeannie Mo, CNN, New York.
All right, guys, it actually looks like a joke, but it's a story. This is real footage. Do you know what is the meaning of real footage?
No.
Like an image?
Real footage is like real video. So this is very commonly used in the States. Oh, we have real footage of the accident or live footage. Good. Guys, how do you say entregas? Delivery. Yep, there's another one, drop off. Ya cuando lo van a dejar. That's the drop off. Okay.
And shipping?
Shipping is envío.
Oh.
Now, drop off son las paradas. For example, a bus full of people can make a lot of drop offs. Drop off, cuando se para a dejar algo o alguien. There's a lot of vocabulary involved today, guys. I really hope that you can take 2 or 3 days to memorize this. Do 7, 10 a day so you can actually remember and use it. Now, what is the meaning of toss?
What is the meaning of what?
Toss.
Can you write?
Double S?
Yep.
Like to toss a...
I've heard the phrase lanzamiento. Toss and turns, but I don't know what it means.
Toss, normally that goes with a coin.
Yeah, okay.
Right? So toss is like when you throw something in the air or to someone. Hey, toss it, man, I'm here. So you toss. Como tirar, right? Arrojar, lanzar.
Throw.
We cannot use launch because it's not a rocket. It's not a campaign. So you see, vocabulary has its context. Now, there is this.
I have a question.
Go ahead.
Is there a difference between toss and throw?
I don't think so. But I can need to double check. Let's do it right now. Toss. Hey, guys. Toss versus throw. If you have questions like this, of course. If I know the answer, I'm gonna share it. Let me see. So, toss is the noun. It's the name of the action. El lanzamiento. And throw is the verb.
Toss is a noun.
Yep, as far as I have here. El lanzamiento, and the other one is the verb. Of course, this is a slightly thing that I just got from the internet. I will need to double check. Toss versus throw. Okay? Now, what is the meaning of these guys that I posted here? I did.
I was going to ask you about that.
To recognize the person in the past.
ID is actually a name, right? Hey, here's my ID. I don't even know what my Instaform ID is, but I have it in my wallet, okay? So that's an ID, but you can also use it as a verb. They have ID'd and identificado. And what about these guys? Surveillance cameras.
Cámara de vigilancia.
Mm-hmm. That's right. Cámaras de vigilancia.
How do you pronounce?
Surveillance. Here, sir. Surveillance. We don't really, there are a lot of sounds in English, guys, that we do not pronounce the vowels. Hey, sir, how are you? How are you, sir? Are you okay, sir? Sir, surveillance cameras.
Surveillance camera.
Mm-hmm. Y eso es otra, guys. Nuevamente, acuérdense, porque eso ya lo había mencionado. La mayoría de palabras que tienen 3 sílabas o más, o sea, las vocales que se pronuncian, cuando la fuerza de voz está en la primera, no se pronuncia la segunda. Por ejemplo, cámara, no se pronuncia así. We don't say camera, we say camera. Camera.
Camera.
Camera.
Camera.
A little bit of
camera.
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 That's
camera.
Right. Not with A, with K. Camera.
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 There you go. Camera. So
camera.
That's one of the rules. Most of the words are like this. Okay, so after thousands and thousands and thousands of words that you're going to have right here, now it's time for you to practice. First step is that I wanted to talk about, again, let's go ahead and think wider than just today's topic. Not only deliveries when shopping online, delivery issues when shopping online, but delivery issues in general. If you have seen a movie, if you have lived that experience, if you know someone who has lived that experience, I wanted to please share with your classmates and use all of the vocabulary we have covered. Now, this vocabulary is gonna be, is gonna disappear, so I'm gonna send it to the WhatsApp group right now, okay? So in the meantime, I wanted to answer, have you lived any experience like this? What is your opinion about it? Give me a second. I only have, okay, JC. I'm moving people from groups, give me a second. All right, guys, go ahead and please accept the, whoopsie. I have 7 unassigned people. Give me a second. Do not accept, please, give me a second. I have a lot of unassigned people. I don't know why. Just a moment. Give me a second. I have to wait for the breakout rooms to close so I can start a new one. In the meantime, guys, how do you say STL?
Chipped.
That's right. Rajado, con una rajadura.
Correct.
All right. How do you say abollado?
Dent.
That's right. Okay. Almost there. Okay, so the breakout rooms have been opened. Go ahead and talk about it, because at the end, you're going to have to use all of the vocabulary or the most of it. Go ahead and accept the invite, guys. Talk about your experience in this topic.
Teacher, how I got into the breakout room again.
Didn't you get the invite?
Yeah, I get it, but I leave the breakout room by mistake.
No worries. I'm going to help you out right now. Give me a second. More, I'm going to assign you in a second too.
It's the same problem.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so Alison and Isabel, you're going to work together. Just let me know if you got it, but do not accept it yet.
Okay.
Did you get it, Alison?
Not really.
I get it.
Okay. All right, go ahead and accept it, More. Roxana is waiting for you. So, Alison, do me a favor. Let me let me know if you got it, please. Do not accept it. Just let me know.
Okay.
Nothing?
Nothing.
What about now?
My internet connection.
Go ahead and change the screens. Like, for example, if you have Google Chrome, change and go back to Zoom.
Okay.
Which one? Estávamos esperando você.
Nothing?
Nothing yet.
Okay, do me a favor. Would you mind logging in and logging back, logging out and logging back in, please? So like immediately, log out of the session and log in again, please.
Okay.
Carlos, why is Juan Carlos alone? Stacy, what's going on?
Andrea, I have a problem with the internet. Maybe have a feedback.
Okay. All right. And let me send you to another group then. Okay. So you're not.
I'm waiting here.
Nah, waiting for her. Come on, man. Let's go ahead and practice in another group.
Okay. Okay.
Companies draw your product.
Yeah.
We have to talk about if we have some experience about that.
Experience, yeah, well, someone you know, or just your opinion about it.
Or my opinion.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay. Well, the video was about
experiences.
It was a real video? Or
it is a real video. That's real
footage. Let me see the real footage.
Yeah, nice, using the vocabulary. Yes, it is.
Yeah,
real.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. For me, the video, it was kind of, I don't know, it doesn't look that it was real, but I don't know.
It looks like a horror movie.
Yes, imagine your TV or something like that. Just
or you a so, new computer, your new Apple laptop.
And they just how do you say tirar? Drop?
Toss.
Mm-hmm. Oh, the toss? Oh.
And they just toss
and
it.
And they just toss it.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
All right. That actually happened to my nephew.
Really?
Yep. He went to the States and he was saving for a long time. He bought a gaming computer over there. It was like more than $1,000 on a computer. And when it came here, it was broken. The glass of the computer was broken.
Wow.
He was super sad because he saved for a long time. He
sad and
long.
Mad.
Sad and mad. Yep. So you see.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
This is give your opinion, make a conversation, go for it. Continue practicing.
Thank you, teacher.
You're welcome.
Thanks. But the glass screen protects better the screen of the cell phone. Teacher, we have a question. You can use Scratch for the screen of the cell phone when you...
Yes.
Okay.
It is Scratch. Now, that's something I forgot to mention, that you can have when you use on, there's a scratch on, it's because it didn't go through.
Mm-hmm.
Right? It's just superficial.
Yeah.
Right? For example, there's a hole on the screen. That means that the screen has a little hole, but mm-hmm. it didn't go through the screen completely. There's a hole in the screen. In that case, yes.
Mm-hmm.
It's like this, the effect.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. It goes through.
Okay. Here we have that question.
Okay. All right. So have you had any experience? What do you think about it? Is it professional? What do you think it happened to the employees? How would you feel as a customer? There are a million things to talk about.
Oh, the video, right?
Yes, about delivery issues, these kind of delivery problems.
Uh-huh.
Not only international, but you know, like a pizza in bad shape, you order from, I don't know, from Ugo app.
Yeah,
and
sometimes on Pizza Hut, like the box, the movement of the motorcycle when they show they deliver the pizza and they say, oh, you want to see the pizza, and they say, oh, okay, and they open the box and it's like
all messed up.
Yes, it's like the pizza on the tape, how do you say, like
the lid, la tapa, lid,
lid.
the lid of the box.
The lid.
Yes. It's
here, not here.
Uh-huh, exactly. Like it was all scrambled inside mm-hmm. the box.
Mm-hmm. Yes, mm-hmm. sometimes.
It happens. All right, yeah, so keep it up. Remember, I mean, if you haven't lived that experience, then give your opinion. That's it. How would you feel? What do you think about it? Continue, guys. Don't be afraid, guys. I'm going to leave you alone, but try not to be so shy, okay?
I see the delivery.
What you, Andrea? Or
yeah.
I think she's having issues with the internet. She's going back and forth.
Okay.
Okay.
Man, you look so happy talking about this. Come on, give it a little bit of flavor, a little bit of color. How would you feel if that happened to you? For example, would you get mad? Would you get frustrated? Would you sue the company?
Yeah, I was saying that I will feel very, very angry or disappointed because you are not expecting to receive your products for the ones you already paid. Mm-hmm. You're not expecting to receive the products in bad conditions. I mean, they are supposed to send the products in mint conditions and because you are paying extra money almost all the time. They charge you extra money when they send the products, like, how do you say, hasta la puerta de tu casa?
To your front door?
To your front door, yeah. They are charging you more money.
Yeah, there are different kinds of deliveries. One, they can just leave it in the porch, for example, and they leave. And there's another kind of delivery where you have to receive it, right? They leave it in the front door. That's what you're saying.
Mm-hmm.
All right, great. Keep it on. We got 5 more minutes, but, you know, has anybody in your family lived this? My nephew saved and worked for a long time to buy a gaming computer. He went to the States with his mom, and he bought a computer for more than $1,000. When it came, it was a gaming computer. When it came, the glass was broken. The glass from the case, from the CPU. I saw that dude crying, but for anger. You have no idea how frustrated he was. I was, oh man, I'm sorry. You know, it happens. Come on, you got 5 more minutes. Oh, add a little bit of flavor to it, guys.
Okay.
But I should for say people that don't go to that flower shop.
What flower shop? What you talking about, girl?
we were talking about these actors that we have seen. And one day on my birthday, my son sent me flowers. But because I was not here yet, and he told them, the man who was delivering, that I was on my way back, the man only dropped the flowers next to the garage door. It was 1 p.m. in the middle of the day with that burning sun, and he just dropped the flowers, not even put them, but just dropped them, and he left. So the flowers were in bad conditions when I came.
All dried. That's a shame. See? That's a shame. Sometimes that happens with cakes. With cakes you order with shapes and stuff. Fondue, is that? No, it's not fondue. Fondango, fondongo, uh-huh. Something like that.
Fondant.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. All right. Okay. Very good. So I want to hear you. I still got a couple of minutes before we go back. What were you saying? How would you feel if this happened to you? Has it happened to a relative? What is your opinion about it? There's a lot to talk.
Ernesto has a story about the Mother's Day, too.
Yeah, I was told him to here. Let's see about the story that I hear from a partner in my work. He shopped a pair of earphones online. But and the problem is that he shoved these earphones at the beginning of the pandemic. I mean, he shoved like in February, and then the pandemic begins on the other side of the world. And
began.
The earphones were in their way. That company gave him like a localizer to see where the product of the purchase was.
A tracking, so, perhaps.
A tracking, right? And the pandemic began when the product was in Shanghai port. I mean, that's another side of the world. So yeah, everything was closed in that place, and ¿cómo puedo decir esto? Como ningún avión estaba esperando. Any airplane was taking off from the airplane.
You can say something like the airports were closed.
Or the airport was closed, right? So he has to wait until 1 month ago. He received finally the purchase, and they gave him the option. They gave him the option to ask for a refund.
And a refund.
He said refund, and he said no. I would like to continue with the purchase, and I will wait for my product, and finally receive it. And it's okay. The earphones are mint in condition, okay, and everything was. But he has to wait a lot of time.
He had to wait. Okay, got it. It sounds like a happy ending at the end.
Yeah.
Good. So in this one, Ernesto, good. I liked it. Make sure you keep the past tense.
Yeah.
Remember that if you're talking to an event, talking about an event that happened in the past, it is already finished, keep the past tense going.
Okay. All right.
And also, whenever you're saying it, normally is on the way, not in. They are on the way.
All right.
Good. Let's go back to the main one, guys. All right, we're gonna have to wait for around 20 seconds for the rest of the people to come back.
I would like to mention that, you didn't mention my name when you took the attendance.
Oh, okay. Yeah, they are working on the thing that you reported right now. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because I sent an email when they say GT something, mm-hmm, and never answer.
Yeah, no, but don't worry. They are working on it, and I already contacted the person in charge, and they sent me several messages about it. They will contact you personally.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm, to give you an answer. All right, guys. I'm sorry?
Make sure they will bring flowers when they contact
Hopefully.
Me.
Hopefully they will. Alrighty, guys. So I need a couple of volunteers, but now.
Me?
Who said me? Okay, Allison. Arnold, give your opinion. Talk about the experience someone else had. Tell me, what would you do in that if that were your package?
I need to leave a moment. Well, I need to close the window.
Go ahead, Maria. Mm-hmm.
Well, sharing with my breakout room mates the story Roxana was telling to us.
Was telling us?
That a relative from her was delivering a very big equipment that didn't fit the road. So the thing came in a wood box, so they have to destroy the wood box to get that thing between the roads because it wasn't big. No, it was very big, sorry.
So like those movies where they transport a complete house, is that what you're telling us?
Yeah, it was not a complete house, but they were, yes. They were trying to ship in a very big equipment.
apartment or equipment?
That could be equipment.
Oh, equipment. Okay, now I got it. I was hearing equipment. Apartment. Okay, all right, good.
No, sorry.
Nah, don't be sorry, guys. Great, thank you very much, Alison. One more volunteer, real quick. Come on, just one. Rule number one, try. Don't make me get the chicken out, guys. Thank you, Amy, for raising your hand. Go ahead and tell us. Hey, you know, if you know who I am and how I am.
I wasn't raising my hand.
Okay, that's not what I saw. Go ahead.
Okay, I will feel very angry if I will receive product or a package in bad conditions, because like I was saying before, you are not expecting to receive your products in bad conditions. And also one of the classmates was telling us that she was waiting for her package, and Correos de Salvador lost the package, and she was waiting for 3 months until receive the package. When the package came,
yeah,
or when
she
received the package, yeah, when she got it, I mean, she was waiting for an iPhone or something like that, and the iPhone was out of the box. I mean, all the package was open, already open, and besides that, she was waiting for 3 months. So in that case, I will be very angry and frustrated.
Frustrated.
Because most of the time, frustrated, uh-huh. Because most of the time you cannot do anything when you receive your package in those conditions. I mean, you have to be just, I don't know, to have like resignation.
Yeah, this is, you can, most likely they are going to say you have to suck it up. That is not like very formal. Es como socarla, you have to suck it up. That is not formal whatsoever. Do not use this language in a job interview or professional environment, but suck it up. It's not vulgar. No es mala palabra ni nada, but it's not professional. Suck it up. Hágale. Sóquela.
Suck it up.
Suck it up. That's right. Good. Thank you very much, Amy. Couple of things, guys. Bad condition is in singular. It's in bad condition. They are in bad condition. Why? Because we use it as an adjective. And in English, the adjectives do not have plural. In Spanish, we can say altos, gordos, bajos, right? Ellos son, etc., ingenieros, right? But in English, por eso tenemos el sujeto to be, el verb to be, perdón. Verb to be, they are tall. Y aquí está el singular, they are. Adjectives are always in singular, okay? And the other one I forgot. So let's go ahead and continue, guys. I forgot about the other one. Before we move forward, I want to give you a couple of announcements. I'm going to say it in Spanish because I want to go plain and go through. Guys, ya acuérdense que cada viernes mando los su progreso. Cada viernes mando su progreso de la plataforma, del homework. Obviamente no hemos terminado la parte 2, así que está bien lo que han hecho. Solo les quiero mencionar que agradecerles porque la gran mayoría ya terminó el homework 1. Pero todavía tengo un par de personas que no están en 100, que están, por ejemplo, en 63, tengo una persona. 84 ya pasa. Tengo otra persona en 96 con el homework 1. Acuérdense que otra persona en 80, el passing score es 80. Una persona más en 80. Así que traten de regresar al homework 1 si quieren tener una súper buena nota al final. Y traten de siempre mantener eso. Igual con el homework 2. Tengo personas con 36, con 32, con 60. que si bien no hemos terminado la unidad 2, es toda esta semana todavía, la unidad 2 dura 2 semanas. ¿Ya? Entonces sí sé que hay ejercicios que faltan por hacer, pero asegúrense de siempre completarlos todos para que cuando termine la unidad ustedes tengan su 100% y no vayan a tener ningún problema con su certificado ni con aprobar el curso. ¿Ok? ¿Alguna pregunta con eso?
Sí, teacher, yo tengo una pregunta.
Dígame.
¿Por qué no me marca, aunque yo comente en los videos, no me lo marca como que ya lo hice? Entonces, no sé qué tengo que hacer para que me lo marque.
Gracias por esa pregunta. Nada. Nada. Los videos en sí no los marcan porque la plataforma no registra ese proceso. Sin embargo, en Safor la audita. ¿Ok? Como yo les mencionaba antes, generalmente al final de la clase, a veces cuando termino de cargar los videos, 1 de la mañana, por algo así, yo vengo y les comento y les pongo lo que necesito que me den. Entonces, yo les aconsejo que comenten a más tardar el siguiente día antes de la clase para que yo les pueda corregir. Si hay algo que corregir, pues se hace. Si no, pues felicidades y se los pongo. Trato de tomarme el tiempo de contestarlos todos, pero solo contesto el del día anterior. ¿Ok? No me voy a regresar hasta la primera clase a contestar ese foro. ¿Por qué? Porque no. O sea, ustedes lo tienen que hacer por requerimiento de Ensafor. Ellos auditan quiénes están participando en el foro, pero yo ya no lo estoy haciendo. Así que si les interesa cumplirle a Ensafor, solo escriban cuando puedan. Si les interesa que yo les ayude en cualquier tipo de corrección, traten de hacerlo el día siguiente. Generalmente trato de que sean cosas súper simples. Así que no cuenta para su nota, por eso es que no se lo marca, pero sí cuenta para proceso de Ensafor. Y lo último, señores, de los announcements. Inscription. Me comentaron ahí que ya les ha llegado el email de inscripción, vea. Yep. Un montón. This movement is not.
Yes.
Este movimiento is not.
Yeah.
So.
Yes, I got it.
Good. Entonces, cuando usted, esto les cae por lo siguiente, todavía nos quedan 3 semanas. All right? 3 more weeks. Esta y las 2 que vienen. Como pueden ver, estoy tratando de darle vocabulario. No todas las clases son de grammar. ¿Ya? Pero sí necesito que vayan con el proceso de inscripción. ¿Por qué se manda con tanto tiempo de anticipación? Porque generalmente a veces en recursos humanos se tarda 1 par de días, semanas, meses. Right?
No.
No todo. Pero sí se tarda. ¿Ok? Entonces, tiene un orden el proceso de recibir la documentación para que puedan ser inscritos nuevamente en Insafor y que puedan seguir disfrutando del beneficio. ¿Qué pasa?
Y estoy con cada curso.
Con cada curso. Cualquier pregunta, estos solo son los basics, los general information. Y eso sí, si la documentación no llega a tiempo, pueden pasar 2 cosas. Número 1, que el grupo en sí, todo el grupo, se atrase. Right? Que no empecemos, digamos, terminamos viernes, empezamos lunes, como tendría que ser, porque me imagino que quieren terminar su curso, tener sus diplomas. Eso es número 1, que todo el grupo se atrase. Número 2, es que si usted no llegó, no entregó la documentación, puede ser que llegue alguien más y esté en su cubra su cupo. ¿Ok? Así que siempre que reciban la documentación, se traten de darle seguimiento con Human Resources para que se mande a tiempo y pues no haya ningún tipo de inconveniente con su inscripción. ¿Alguna pregunta con la inscripción? Any questions with the inscription?
No.
¿Has el water water clear?
No. Not that much.
Not that much.
Yo tengo una pregunta.
Go ahead. Who's talking? ¿Quién habla?
Me, Amy.
Oh, there you go.
Pero no es de la inscripción. Solo quiero saber si al final de este curso, o sea, en 2 semanas y media, sí nos van a dar diploma de este curso.
Sí, eso está, el diploma se carga en la plataforma. Es digital y si ustedes lo quieren en físico, creo que tendrían que contactar con administración. Pero sí, tienen su diploma de que han completado. All right. Now, siempre se los digo algo, eso sí, a veces la gente no le molesta este comentario, pero los diplomas Si ustedes no hablan, no les sirven de nada. ¿Ok? Así que espero que todos aquí, la verdad, que hablan, se defienden, veo que quieren. Pero un diploma no es como el universitario o de bachiller, que no solo lo ocupa para trámites prácticamente. Si usted le hace una entrevista, so, do you speak English? Yes. So, tell me, why do you want to apply for this position? Yes. Fuera. No le sirve para nada el diploma. So, guys, do your best, right? It's not about the name, it's about the knowledge.
I have another question.
Go ahead.
Is there any other group from a different time?
Schedule?
Schedule, sorry, because my aunt is also student with InSupport, and she's in a group from 7 to 9 p.m. I don't know if in this place should be the same schedule.
I'm not sure on the schedules. That will be directly with administration.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. I think that it depends on the demand. It depends on, I don't know the requirements. Siempre, señores, les voy a decir las cosas como las sé o como no las sé. Mi parte es lo académico. Pero sí sé más o menos cómo va admin, pero cualquier consulta ya específica ya sería con con administration.
Okay. All right? Thank you.
Good. So, clear on that. Homework, we're all clear. And forum, we are clear. Right? Good. I'd like to hear you.
Mm-hmm. I have another question.
Go ahead, shoot me.
I'm actually seeing my progress.
Mm-hmm.
I can see that in week one, I have the thing completed. I have also the week two, three, and that schema, grafica.
The graphic? Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the graphic. And at the end, the total is 11%. This is not the final grade.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Now, remember, guys.
We completed as long as we completed the other week.
The thing is that, exactly. Remember that you have to complete homework one, homework two, homework three, homework four, homework five. The midterm, which is due this week. That's very important, guys. We have a midterm this week. El viernes, prácticamente, yo le voy a estar ayudando haciendo un repaso de todos los temas. Porfa, no me falten el viernes. Right? También el miércoles, a las personas que ya tienen su calendarización, busquen preguntas acerca de eso. Okay? Porque, y eso te cuenta también, Allison, y tenemos el final test. Entonces, yeah. Por eso es que te sale nada más 11%, porque te está cubriendo week one, perdón, homework one, el pedazo de la dos,
sí.
Ajá, yeah. Y te falta todo lo demás. O sea que ya estás en un 11% más cerca, si lo quieres ver positivamente. Good, keep it up. So, guys, rocking it real quick. Ana María Mazojín Rivera. No. Javier Rodrigo Ayala Córdoba. And Sara Elizabeth Ruiz Ortiz.
And me.
And you. And you, Maria Isabel. Alrighty, my dear fellows. So this is what we're going to do. I need two volunteers. The last person who shows something yellow to the camera is going to be one of my volunteers. Something yellow. You got to move it. Okay, you're saved. Saved, saved. Something yellow. If you don't have it, you're going to be a volunteer.
Flower.
Uh-huh. Say whatever it is. Yellow, yellow, yellow. Uh-huh. Okay, so Danielito, you are... Oh, you got saved. It's between David Orlando. Okay. Eric Arnaldo, thank you very much. More, don't hide. Okay, thank... Okay, uh-huh. All right, so I got Morena, Eric Arnaldo, and David. This is what we're gonna do. Are you good improvising? No? Let's find out. No. I'm gonna give you 1 minute round, guys, for you to prepare on the spot right now a role play using the vocabulary we have covered. You can talk about whatever you want. Just go with the flow. Hey, man, I just got my new phone. Oh, my God, this Ukraine is so chipped. I can't believe this. It took me 3 months. Right? So, improvise it. Are you ready?
But it's going to be personal.
Now it's going to be between Eric Morena and David Orlando. You have 1 minute.
Okay.
Come on, show us what you're made of, guys. You ready? Ready or not, 3, 2, 1, go.
Hey, Celia, I want to tell you something. Hey, Celia. Morena, I want to tell you something. You know that I went to the store, but I went to the store and I bought a jeans, but the jeans is stained. It got a black stain on the right leg of my jeans. It was awful, man. So I suggest you don't go to that store. Have you been in a situation like this? And what do you do?
Continue, More. Then you're next, David.
I'm so sorry for you, but maybe you have to. You have to change the product in this case, I suppose. And maybe try with another store.
Okay, thank you.
We have only 2 minutes.
No, continue, because you took like 20 seconds to start. David, go.
You should change your cell phone, bro. And you have to be careful when you go to the gym. And you have to buy a pocket where you can put save your cell phone, and that way you cannot waste a lot of money.
Okay, all right, there you go. Hey guys, round of applause. I know this is not easy. Good job, good job, good job, good job, good job, good job. Excellent. So, were you nervous, guys?
Yes, good.
I really hope the rest of you are nervous as well. This is not about English. This is about working with your fears. Okay, the last person showing me something round. Huh? Move it. Something
what
round.
Is that?
Round. Redondo. Okay, good. Alison, you're saved. Saved. Roxana. Save, Don Edgardo, save, Beatriz, save, Juan Carlos.
What happened?
Keep it. Ahí manténgalo, que si no, no sé quién lo puso, no. Keep it there. What? Eric, again, María Isabel.
Something wrong.
María Isabel.
María Isabel.
What?
Okay, thank you very much, María Isabel. Eric, you again, come on, brother. Okay, so give me something else. You're going to have 1 minute. Remember, it's about delivery. You cannot use stained because they already used it. Go, surprise us. Eric and Maria Isabel, 1 minute for both. Go.
Me?
Yeah,
but
go,
I saw the
go.
Wrong thing.
Nah, yeah, but the last. Go. Time's running. Improvise it.
Who am I talking to?
Jason? To Eric. Go, no? Go,
Maria Eric. Isabel.
Okay.
Hey, Maria Isabel, what's going on? Hey,
I'm fine. I'm fine.
And
you? Did you get the things that you ordered the other day?
Yeah, but it was awful because my windshield was cracked. I don't know why, because they delivered the windshield in that way.
Did you call them to complain?
I tried to call them, but they say just the raw material was broken. I don't know, but it's an explanation that I can't imagine. Just a full guy could say something like that.
You're right to be disappointed. I think that you should text them, write them or something, or call them. Maybe you can have your money back. You should.
Yeah, I hope so. I would like to get my money back because now that it's winter, I guess
10 seconds.
The windshield is going to be leaking all the way down when I come to work.
Yeah, that could be
and my electronic devices.
Yeah,
because my electronic devices.
Okay, great. Time. Good job. Many vocabulary used. Great. Okay. Turkey face, everybody. That doesn't exist in English. That's, you know, Salvadorian translated to English. I needed to show me something. Let me make it difficult. Something triangular. triangular. How are you gonna find it? I have no idea.
Triangular.
Triangular. Come on, move it and keep it there. Keep it there so I can see it. Yeah.
Triangular.
Same. Yes. Triangular. Yes. That's squared. Keep it. Yeah. Keep it. Keep it. Yes. 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 Keep it there. Keep it shown. Hi, Roxanita. You're almost there. Oh, you got saved. Uh-huh. Keep it there. Apparently, Juan Carlos is going to be one.
No.
Gladys is going to be another one, I think. Amy, what the hell is
draw
that?
Draw it, guys. Draw a triangular.
Okay, that's not triangular. Okay, Beatriz, thank you very much. Juan Carlos. And Gladys, thank you, guys. Demole. Okay, so try to use different vocabulary than the ones used. Beatriz is going to start, Juan Carlos is going to continue, and Gladys is going to finish. All right, so ready or not, 3, 2, 1, go.
Okay. Hello, guys. My car was broken. I crashed in the Los Chorros Street, and I don't know. Help me.
Okay.
Come on. Okay.
What's the problem? Your car is
the direction. The direction move, and I crash in a tree.
Ah, we have a problem. We need to talk a mechanic and to try to repair this direction. Maybe it's broken. The drive is hard.
Continue, Gladys.
Yes, when you have a terrible scratches on your car, I think that you can take them to this company that I know that is very, that they make wonderful repairs on the car. So I'm gonna pass you the phone later.
Yes, please help me because it's a lot of smoke. Humo.
Smoke.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, smoke.
Great. There we go again. Excellent. Okay, so good job, Gladys, Juan Carlos, Beatriz. I know it's not easy, and I'm going to try to make it more difficult for the next one. So, turkey face with the object. Now, I want you to show me something. The last one showing a shoe is going to pass. The last one showing a shoe, a sandal, and keep it there so I can see it.
Sounds right.
Shoe, sandal, whatever it is. Shoe. Keep it there. Keep it there. Saved. Eric, saved. Maria Isabel.
I have a shoe.
Oh, you have a shoe. David. Beatriz, a usted le gusta participar. Okay, Beatriz and David. So now, 1 minute, you're going to have, it's going to be a delivery issue with a computer. All right?
Repeat me, please.
The delivery issue with computer. David, you there? David, Orlando?
Yes, I'm here. Yes,
okay.
I'm here.
Rocket, my man, you got 1 minute. You start, Beatriz continues. 3, 2, 1, go.
Hi, Beatriz. I have a problem with my computer.
Delivery issue.
I order it. When I receive it, the screen was scratched. As well, the computer had a crack in the middle of the screen.
Oh my God! Okay, so you called to the company.
Okay. Yes, I did.
Okay, and can you talk to the company and talk about that, and I don't know if you want to if they help you. So that's my recommendation.
I don't know if you can.
Okay, good enough, good enough. I'm gonna stop your suffering right there. Good job, good job. There we go again. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Okay, we got two more. Good job, David, Beatriz. I know it's not easy, guys, but you know,
thank you, teacher.
As I told Amy, you gotta suck it up. That's what you're here for, right? Okay, so the last one showing me, just two more and then you can relax.
Just one, not two.
Just one, not two. Okay.
Found.
The last one showing me a bill or a coin. A bill or a coin. Doesn't matter if it's
a coin.
A bill or a coin.
A bill or a coin.
Keep it in front of the camera so I can see who's doing it. Okay, you're saved, Andrea. You're saved, Amy. Save. Keep it there, Gladys. Oh, if you only handle credit cards, you're in trouble. Uh-huh, good. Uh-huh, nice, nice.
I'm the victim. I don't have any of that near.
Okay, very good. Isabel, and I'm waiting for the next victim. You're saved. Saved, saved. It's between Aldo and Juan Carlos.
I have to watch my hands, teacher.
Hey.
Me too.
Yeah.
That's why I always have it right next to me. Okay. Good. Alison and Aldo. The word is lick.
Lick.
Three. I know it's difficult to receive something that is licking, but you know, do whatever you gotta do.
It's always
three.
Receiving.
Yep.
Or
delivery issues. Lick. Allison, you start. Aldo, you continue. Go.
Okay. Well, hello, Aldo. I just received a soup from El Sopón, La Sacamil. And they sent me a package that is leaking, and it's sopa de pata. And I'm so sad that all of the liquid is leaking. I don't know what to do now because I called them and they didn't answer.
And when you received the package from the, you didn't saw that the whole soup was on the bag?
Was in the bag. Mm.
Not really. They gave me a black bag. So I thought it was because they told me they sent me a fresco. So I thought it was the fresco, not the soup.
Wow. And have you already called them again? And
pause. Nice story about your sopa de pata, girl. Good job. Thank you, Aldo. Thank you, Alison. Good.
I thought I was thinking that she will talk about the garrobo.
Consomé.
Consomé de garrobo.
Don't talk about that, because
I didn't think of that.
I had two iguanas. I went on vacations, and when I came, I just have one. So that makes me sad, man. I lost one of my animals. Alrighty. So this is the last one, so you can get out of here. And this one is going to be a little bit exotic. Okay? A sock. Show me a sock. Come on, Rocket. Don't worry about the smell because nobody else can feel it. Okay, so a sock. Okay, keep it there. A sock. It doesn't matter if it's not yours. Okay.
Good.
There you go. You're saved. JC, safe. Finally, JC, you got it near. I think Roxana is gonna pass.
I pass.
Okay, so thank you very much. Carmina, Celia, where's yours?
Here.
Ah, okay, good. And what about yours, Beatriz? Ah, muchachita. Okay, Roxana, half an hour later. Roxana and Beatriz.
No.
So, Roxana, you start. You gotta use dent. Go for dent. It. Dent.
What is dent? Abollado.
Abollado. Vocabulary. Three, two, one. After this, you can go home.
Okay.
Three, two. Well, you are home, I hope. Three, two, one, go.
Oh, no. Somebody went to my car and they dent my
door car.
Yes, the door, because you already said
the door. The door. The door of my car. And who is
Bea?
Yeah, okay, Bea.
Okay, oh my God, I can't believe you. So, you know the person who made that?
No, I don't know who was. But it's my new car. So they don't make cars like all times.
So, I agree.
You will pay for that because you don't. I don't know. You don't.
Didn't. Okay. 1 minute, guys. Round of applause. Thank you very much. Alrighty, guys. So that's going to be all for today. Remember, I'm going to try to push you as far as I can. Get out of your comfort zone and keep on improving, doing your best. Write down the vocabulary, okay? Get out of here. See you tomorrow. Have a good night.
See you tomorrow.
Yeah.
Good night.
See you.
Good night.
See you, bye.